Good morning, children. Good morning to the online classroom of Chanakya Academy. You all are welcome to the online session. Today, we are going to start with chapter number 3 of subject organization of commerce and management, that is OC. By now, children, you have learned the meaning of management, functions of management, functional areas of management, why we need to do the management. If you recall the functions of management, it included planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling, right? So from this chapter, chapter number 3, we will be discussing about each and every function of management in detail. This chapter number 3, is discussing about the first function of planning, or first function of management, or the first step of management, that is known as planning. So my question to you is, what is the meaning of planning? Any examples? Think on yourself. Okay, next question is, have you ever done planning? Okay, let us discuss few common examples of planning that we are doing in our day-to-day life. Okay, like when you have to go out, say for 2 days, a picnic for 2 days, you plan for the route, you plan for the vehicles you want to take, you also plan for the route that you will go through, you also plan for the clothes that you want to take, you plan for the food that you want to take, you plan for the different enjoyments and recreations that you are going to do at the place you visit, right? So these are the different types of planning that you do for one simple objective, that is when you go for a picnic, what you are going to do, right? So going at the picnic spot is your objective, and deciding the different ways, methods, plans, activities is all what is included in your planning. तो प्लानिंग में आप वहाँ पहुँच के वहाँ पे एंजॉय करने के लिए जो जो चीज़ें करते हो, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड इन प्लानिंग, राइट? इन द सेम वे, इफ वी टॉक इन द लैंग्वेज ऑफ कॉमर्स और मैनेजमेंट, तो एवरी बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज हैविंग द गोल्स, डिफरेंट गोल्स. फॉर वन पर्टिकुलर ईयर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मे डिसाइड टू अर्न हाइएस्ट प्रॉफिट. For any particular year, organization may decide to produce maximum production, or it may even decide to increase the profit to contribute for the social development, right? So, इस तरह के अलग अलग objectives हर बार organization के होते हैं. They may even decide to set up the new plant or expand the current plant, right? So, in all these situation, to achieve these targets, various planning is done, like planning for expansion of say industrial unit. What kind of planning is required? Fund kahan se aayega? How to get the machineries, where to install the machines, and so on. Business is a in today's session, we are going to discuss about introduction, what is the meaning of planning, characteristics of planning, and limitations of planning. These are the points that we'll cover today. Let us first start with the concept of the introduction. See children, business is nothing but an economic activity with the main profit of earning, with the main motive of earning profit. So to earn that profit, we as a business enterprise or an organization has to collect various informations, has to perform various activities, well in advance, like how much production is to be done, when the production is to be done, by what quantity production is to be done, who will be involved in this production process, and so on. So with this, can we say that planning is forecasting the future in the present? In present, we are going to discuss about the things, the activities that we are going to do in the future. Planning is a universal process. It is not required only in the subject of OC. It is not required only in the company. It is also not required only for one or two particular type of business. But for every small activity, it requires planning. Jaise ground pick, to play in the ground, to run the business, in a battlefield, going on a picnic, playing with friends, political institution, religious temples, social institute, everything requires planning. So, what is planning? We are having different concepts and definitions. What we want to achieve in future and how, for this, various alternatives are to be considered, and that out of all these alternatives, the best has to be selected. For example, going to a picnic spot, we are having three different options. We can either take our mopeds, we can even go with the cars, and we can even use the public transport. If we have to consider the financial position, then we may go for the public transport to reach the picnic spot. But on the other hand, if we want to go for a luxury, we may even opt to go for the car. So, selecting the best alternative out of all available alternatives is planning. Concept: planning is to collect information for the activities to be undertaken in business, consider them in advance, and plan how to do these activities. We are having two different definitions given by Bill Goetz and George Terry. Bill Goetz say that task of planning is choosing. Planning ka matlab hota hai selection. Jitne alternative available hai, usme se select karo. Hamara jo target hai, uske liye jo task perform karna hai, usko select karo. Whereas George Terry defined planning means assumption of result, policy to follow the function, stages, and to decide the method to be followed. So by now, tell me one thing, that when you decided for the picnic spot, what actual activity you did? Did you move to the picnic spot? Did you inquire to the ST workshop? Did you inquire to your friend for the car? Did you went to fill up the petrol in your car? Did you prepare the food? No. Everything was done mentally. That is, you will do like this, you will do like this, on so on. All the different steps were prepared mentally. And that is why planning is said to be an intellectual process to achieve the organizational goals. Right, children? So by now, I hope that you are clear the meaning with the meaning of planning. Ki hum planning kisko bolte hain? Planning means koi bhi target ko ya objective ko achieve karne ke liye jo sequence of steps, policies, rules hum follow karte hain, jo that is known as planning. Planning is completely an intellectual process. That means it requires the mental exercise to be followed. We have to think for the various options available, various alternative available, and then we have to select the best possible alternative. Let us have a look at the characteristics of planning. Already said, planning is an universal process. That means that planning is present in every field, like business, politics, education, religion, or even social. Primary function. Why is it said to be the primary function? Because rest all the functions like organize karna, staff select karna, employees ko direct karna, control karna, everything based on planning. Planning is the primary function of management, as management starts with planning, and all the other functions of planning like organization, staffing, directing and controlling are implemented on the basis of planning. It is conscious and mental process, because in planning, decisions are taken consciously on the basis of calculative assumption. Why it is said to be conscious and a mental process? Because you cannot take any emotional or biased decision. To go for the proper or successful planning, it requires calculation and assumption. These calculations are based on the data that is collected. Calculative assumptions, based on the collected data, we forecast for the future. Flexibility. Planning contains various calculations, assumptions. Business enterprise is also affected by external factors like government, say natural calamities or any artificial calamities or such epidemics or pandemics, that is right now we are going through that, right? Changes should be made in the planning as per the time, circumstances and situation. Say for example, one of the company has decided to produce 50,000 units in the one particular year, but as of now we are knowing that we are going through the situation of lockdown, yani ki ek month ka complete agar plant band hoga, so is it possible to arrange the same achieve the same target? No, it becomes bit difficult, and to achieve the same hame kya karna padega, again necessary changes planning mein karne padenge. Jaise in our prior calculation we had decided that we will be going with the 8 hours working for the men, and if we continue the production on Sundays also, then we will be able to achieve the target. Now when you know that when the lockdown was there, that means 30 days ka plant shutdown tha. If you calculate for 8 hours on one day, that means 240 man hours were already wasted. 8 hours per day into 30 days. So 240 man hours are to be recovered. यानी कि लॉकडाउन कंप्लीट होगा तब क्या करेंगे? देन अगेन वी विल गो विद 12 आवर्स ऑफ शिफ्ट फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज? 60 डेज, दैट इज नेक्स्ट 2 मंथ्स. एंड दिस इज हाउ जो भी हमारा बैकलॉग हुआ है, जो भी प्रोडक्शन का कम प्रोडक्शन हुआ, दैट कैन बी, दैट टारगेट कैन बी अचीव्ड. सो आई कैन से दैट प्लानिंग इज फ्लेक्सिबल, बिकॉज उसके अंदर कैलकुलेशन और एजम्पशंस तो हैं, बट अलॉन्ग विद दैट फॉर चेंजेस इन एनी एक्सटर्नल फैक्टर्स नेसेसरी प्लानिंग कैन नेसेसरी चेंजेस इन द प्लानिंग कैन बी मेड. फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज़ अ प्री कंडीशन फॉर द प्लानिंग. प्रिसाइज, एज इट इज़ द प्रोसेस ऑफ फ्यूचर, मैटर्स कंसिडर्ड फॉर द प्लानिंग आर टू बी स्टडीड एग्जैक्टली. Like all the statistical data collected information must be very precise and accurate. Forecasting is essential. Forecasting is done by considering future uncertainties. Hum ye maan ke chalte ki if any say lockdown occurs, then it will be of 10 to 15 days or 1 month. So what will be done in such situation, as we are going to produce a seasonal product, right? If the selling is less, then how can we increase the selling? If any employees goes on strike during the production process, then how to tackle the problem, right? So in such situation, forecasting is done by considering the future uncertainties. Therefore, forecasting and planning are considered as the first function of management. Listing out the alternative. Planning in any field requires various plans and alternatives. There can be many alternatives to increase the sales in future. Ek example hum lete hain. We can increase the sales through advertisement. We can increase by giving more product or more quantity. We can increase by reducing the price. Out of that, selecting the best alternative is what is done in planning. Jaise if you have to sell, say, the good, you can call it a mango squash, that is a drink that is generally consumed in the summer days. Ab iska product now when to produce, whether to produce in the winter and to store in the warehouse, or whether to produce it just before the arrival of summer, or once, say for example, we decided to produce just before the arrival of summer so that it goes fresh with all the consumers. Now, how to increase the sale? To do the advertisement on television, to do the marketing activities. For marketing, if it is to be done on television, or if it is to be done on radio, or if it is to be done on the printed media, or how to increase the sale, whether to reduce the price, whether to increase the quantity, and out of that selecting the best alternative is what we do in planning. For example, if we are going to sell the same in the urban areas, then we can go with the printed media or television. If we are going to sell the same in the rural areas, we can go with the printed media or a salesman who will go door to door to give the information. So, list of alternative and selection of the best. It is concerned with future. So, definitely uncertainties are involved, assumptions are done, and as in short, planning is related with future because evaluating future at present and making arrangement for the same. Planning is continuous process. It is not so ek bar aapne planning kar diya, your task is done. Aapne planning kar diya, picnic jana hai, wahan pe jaake kya food leke jaoge, kaun sa vehicle ka use karoge, then usko implement karoge. Right? So planning is a continuous and perennial process. It begins with the establishment of organization and continues till the end. Jab tak aap wahan pahunch nahi jate, wahan pe enjoy nahi karte, games different play nahi karte, return back to home is the last step till their planning continues. Objective oriented activity. Planning is made on the basis of achieving the objective. हम प्लानिंग क्यों करते हैं? सो दैट वी कैन अचीव द प्री डिटरमाइंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. मैनेजमेंट डिसाइड्स फ्यूचर टारगेट्स एज पर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस बिजनेस. इट रिक्वायर्स डिसीशन मेकिंग. प्लानिंग इन्वॉल्व सिलेक्शन ऑफ बेस्ट ऑल्टरनेटिव एंड फॉर दैट वी रिक्वायर टू मेक द डिसीशन. नाउ लेट अस मूव अहेड regarding the importance of planning. Okay, see, planning is a vital or important for business and an outline for the future. Planning is in all the field, hence government sector, private sector, or different other organization make plans for their activities, like central government. And central government has accepted the importance of planning, and that's why they have set up a planning commission whose main task is to set up different plans and activities for the economic development of the country. What is the importance of planning? If planning is done, activity will be done systematically as per the plan. Wastage can be reduced. We can even reduce the future uncertainties or loss that can be occur because of these uncertainties. It also leads to precision and accuracy. We can go with the accurate work. It is useful in achieving the objectives. It makes management function smooth because even a manager knows the sequence of step to be followed to do the activities. It increases the employee cooperation and harmony. Effective control becomes possible with the planning. Now, last topic of today that we are going to discuss is about, limitations of planning. अब हम प्लानिंग की लिमिटेशंस क्या हैं? सी चिल्ड्रन, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट प्लानिंग और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स और बेनिफिट्स, इट इज़ नॉट नेसेसरी दैट ऑल द लिमिटेशंस आर अप्लाइड. Limitations depends on the size of organization, type of organization, type of objectives. Clear? First, as you all know that planning is about uncertain future. Planning is based on assumptions and data of past, and forecasting is based for future. But future is completely uncertain. Therefore, we cannot say that the planning will be successful. Assumptions may not be fully correct. So, uncertainties, risk of uncertainty is always there in planning. Expensive process, a bit expensive process, because doing the managerial activity and planning requires experts. They are charging high fees. Moreover, along with the financial expense, there are planning requires ample amount of time, energy, and so it becomes an expensive process. Planning is time consuming. We have to collect different information, we have to analyze the same information, classify it, and then we can move with the planning, and so it is said to be a time consuming process. As planning involves uncertainties, it becomes irrelevant due to time, sometimes circumstances, political or social factors that affect the business, and there in all these situations planning may fail. For example, planning is irrelevant, or you can say planning may fail based on the different factors. Like if earthquake happens, then plant has to be shut down for indefinite period of time. If any strike is there, then plant may be shut down for 1 or 2 days or a week, right? If depending on all these factors, if say activities affect on a long, then planning can, if such things are not taken into consideration in the planning, then planning may fail. One more limitation is that it tends towards rigidity. Planning is adopted for future, but if we take planning as a strict option to be followed, then it leads to rigidity. Situation may occur that managers, employee do not take risk of deviating from the plan, and in such situation they follow as per the planning, which may leads to rigidity. Yani aapko, you don't find different innovation or ideas to be implemented. Just to avoid the risk, we strictly follow it, and it makes the plan rigid. External factors are always on the risk of getting affected. Yani ki business pe different external or factors ki wajah se business mein changes aate rehte, which may even every time required to alter the planning. Planning may sometime provide incomplete information, or planning based on incomplete or inaccurate information may not give you the exact result of the objective. Restrictions on employees' creativity. Implementation of planning is done by employees of the business unit. Though employees have creativity, they cannot make any changes, and due to this, it restricts the creativity of employees. If managers have made the plan and they want employees to strictly follow it, then in such situation, it leads to employees' creativity. Iska best example do, jo hum starting se discuss karte hain, right? Deciding the different types of games to be played at the picnic spot, right? For example, while sitting at home, we had decided that we are going to play the cricket, or we may even play the football as there is availability of big ground, right? And if when we move at that particular place, we find that the ground is not large enough, and we decide to play some sport like badminton or something, right? But if से आई हैड मेड द प्लानिंग, भाई हमको क्रिकेट ही खेलना है, एंड आई रिस्ट्रिक्टेड द पर्सन टू टेक द बैडमिंटन रैकेट्स विद देम, और इवन इफ वी हैड टेकन आई रिस्ट्रिक्टेड, नहीं हमने प्लान किया था क्रिकेट खेलना या नहीं, हम क्रिकेट ही खेलेंगे. तो दिस इज द सिचुएशन दैट कैन अकर इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑल्सो, वेयर प्लानिंग रिस्ट्रिक्ट द क्रिएटिविटी ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज एंड यूज ऑफ faulty methods. If different faulty methods or irrelevant methods of statistics are used, then the information so derived may not be appropriate, and in this situation planning may fail. So children, let us have a quick revision of the things that we have already studied today. Is planning, meaning of planning, different definitions given by Bill Goetz and George Terry, the different 11 characteristics of planning like universal process, primary function, conscious and mental process, flexible, precise, forecasting, list of alternatives, it is related with future, continuous process, decision making. Importance of planning, why we do such planning is, usse wastage kam hoga, we can do the activity systematically, future uncertainties can be reduced, we can accomplish the objectives, coordination can be done, but सामने limitation क्या है, we are doing work for the uncertain future, it is time consuming and expensive process, risk of external factor is always there which can make the changes in the planning or can alter the plan. With this I would like to conclude our today's session. Tomorrow we will move ahead with the process of planning, types of planning and elements of planning. Till then, bye, take care, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you.